Right. Well, that's pretty exclusive, this.
Yeah. Okay, so a quick overview. So we need a new API. I think everyone here already knows why, so I'm not going to go over it in great detail. The existing one is a bit shit, and it's really the historical reason, is everybody's going to change, so we'll have to follow suit. To make our lives better, FPA support works, choose to use your FPA or not, fix floating point issues. So there's an awful lot of code we've already fixed to get it to work, which will never be done fixing. What else? It provides binary compatibility with other systems, which is interesting and exotic. So in theory, you can run the same code on stuff produced by ADS, ARTADS, Linux, GCC, Linux, and Symbian, and those things, which is only really something proprietary people care about on the floppy with codecs. We don't particularly want to help there, but I think it'll be a side effect. So at the moment, there's two flavours of new ABI-ness. There's the old kernel syscalls with a glibc with some shims in it, which is what you get with glibc 2.3.6 and the code source 3.4 toolchain. And then there's all shiny new ABI proper with a new kernel and a new glibc, which is GCC 4.1, glibc 2.4, or 2.3.7, which I don't think is out yet, and kernel 2.6.16 or later. So it's all pretty shiny and new. That's the kind of fundamental background. Does that make sense to everyone? Maybe you lost. Where are we at? We picked a name after a lot, lot of ranting. For a new Debian ARM architecture, for which Guillaume's just posted a patch, so we can call that basically done, unless someone probably needs to test it. In terms of actually getting this working, Ricky built a user space with code sourcery cross toolchain. So that's the shim flavour of doing things, which basically worked. Martin Guy has been working on getting the new toolchain stuff working. He's been using CrossTool, partly because he's not really a Debian person, so he can get his head around all the Debian CrossTool stuff, and mostly because I just had an extra layer of stuff that didn't work. It's easier to get it cross-building with CrossTool Vert and then worry about the Debian packaging. So that now builds kernels and boots on QEMU using an old style user space. I think Kevin of the OE project built a shiny new toolchain as well, which basically works for supporting various things that go wrong, because with a new major version of glibc and GCC, various things are broken. I know Guillaume and Nokia have been doing stuff. You should probably tell us exactly where we're at, if you know.
About Guillaume?
Yeah, and what works and what doesn't, and how far you've got.
Didn't issue.
Not really. I think they're still using all the code sourcery cross toolchain rather than trying the shiny new latest. Dr. Elliot Foster has been hand booting Debian with the code sourcery toolchain. He's got a native build that works. So yes, lots of efforts. I'm not sure anyone's quite got all the new stuff. They have a root file system, which is all new style, which I think is where we'll get
to. Oh, it probably has.
Yeah, probably actually. It's a bit on them here. So anyway, the question really is, I talked to AJ, he's been one of the people who expressed the opinion that we want to make old ARM work, new style. So I explained to him why that was really, really hard, and he went, okay, yeah, fair enough. So I think everyone agrees on which way we're going, then starting a new port. The suggestion was, so the extra complexity of supporting old ARMs, i.e. strong ARM, isn't that old, but it is discontinued. The long build structure is still a bit at the moment. because it's on V4 instead of V4T, it doesn't do thumb in working, which is part of the spec. Now, I don't think we actually care much about thumb in working, but on the other hand, it'd be nice not to break it in case someone wants to use thumb in stuff in the future. And a novel has been suggested to avoid using the instruction that doesn't exist. So we have an extra two instructions in every function call. So we'll be a slight inefficiency, but I don't think that's critical. And it would be, we just need to modify GCC to do that normally, but have a CPU optimization for the case where you've got something newer than strong arm, so it's easy to rebuild. I think that's what it's called.
The CPUX instruction?
Yeah, that's right. So that'll mean we'll be doing a slightly different ABI than everyone else. I'm not sure if that introduces any incompatibilities. I don't think so, but I'd like to be sure before we go that route. If we don't do that, then we can leave hold on for strong arm. AJ didn't rule out the possibility of releasing this with Edge ready. That's not impossible, but I think it's very likely. If we suddenly find the tool chains, well, the tool chains seem to have just about started working now, so in theory, we've got some build machines.
Why not the tool chain freeze?
That's true.
When is it? This?
Well, I think we'll find out when it's talk, which is in like 15 minutes or something.
Okay. Actually, I've got that mail up from earlier. TPM was saying if we want to get a 4.1, we've got to have it done by. Sometime or other. But yeah, it's like a month away or something. It's not very long. So you're right, the chances of getting definitive tool chain by then are pretty low, I'd say. But about 5 we can
go more or less
for all and stuff.
Yeah,
so
yes, I can remember quite a few.
Right. I've got some fancy hardware arm, which is intended for this purpose, and I can just get it working. So that's got file system, which is old style of new API. So I can build stuff now. I can set it to remote reset it, so I can build with it from here. So yes, what I really want, I'm not quite sure whether to build stuff with what exists in terms of the kind of old kernel shimmy-glibc and get a root of S and start building things and then worry about updating those to all new, or if we should, if that's going to cause an endless trouble, and it's better to just get a whole new, all new ABI tool chain and then start from building. Because we get a different set of bugs of GCC 3.4 versus 4.1 anyway.
Right.
But apart from that, I'm not sure it makes too much difference, it's just the other versions, really. I don't know, what does anyone else think? I've talked too much. And maybe what we should actually just do is sit down and try. There's pages and pages of stuff about building tool chains from Martin. And what I'd like to do is try putting a new tool chain into the crocodile thing and seeing if it spits out a root file system. Theory, it should just work beautifully. I'd like to see how broken that is today. Because if that works, that's then just a matter of making what build all that stuff work and setting it off. Because what we need is some web page. So we've got the standard Debian interface with the build D pages saying this broke and that broke and got here. So everything
you can get an experimental one, sure.
Exactly. So I'm sure that lets in the moment we have a machine that works. So I want to get to a machine that works as soon as possible. I'm not quite sure what the least painful way of doing that is. And maybe using Elliot's stuff or even refuse to. Because did you get as far as a native GCC? I think you didn't, did you?
No, I didn't.
No. So Elliot's got one and Arm got one. I'm not quite sure if they're both machine style. I'm not sure if the problem is that if you build anything like that for the assumed glibc, whether that interworks with stuff built for glibc 2.4 or shiny and new.
strategies is, you know, stop here and then want to develop one thing here.
That seems to be working relatively well the last couple of days.
Yeah.
So, and I need a bit of help with one of those last time I tried to set it up for work. But in fact, it requires a bootstrap image for the standard setup, and you go, well, that's no good, we haven't got one of those. So presumably you can set it up to just build on box instead of within a cheroot. Anyone know? No?
I don't think you can get one of those to build a base system if you don't have one.
No, so we get a base system using
the
base system.
Yeah, you have to find a base system.
Right, yeah. So, okay, so we can then just put that in a cheroot.
Yes, if you have a base system, you can just put
it in the wall. Right.
Well, I think so. It's also because there are a lot of limitations like QC, you have to do those needs. Because it needs DTEC to build the mount, the info files, something like that. And DTEC then depends on X because it includes XDVR.
There we go.
So you have to do it by hand.
I'm glad you need to build a lot of no docs to just chop all this stuff off. It's so shit.
So one build is not good. Yeah, crocodile probably.
There's only one build experts here.
That's true.
Amber's father is running already the big Indian army.
That's right. Yes.
Amber's witches. I'm sorry.
A big Indian army.
He's already running big Indian.
Yeah, that was a different thing.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Getting them buildings set up. Yeah. And it's a very long tool actually.
Yeah.
Basically, point to the box and say
a box with base.
It needs base.
Yeah.
So I think right now we need to get a new base built. We can think about that actually. I think. Is there anything else we need to decide in terms of who's doing what? I'm not quite sure what the OE people have done doing. I suppose they've got a special OE magic script. Basically equivalent to the cross-tool magic script to produce a tool chain. There's a secondary question of actually getting Debian packaged versions of the new tool chain. So because Martin has been doing all this cross-tool stuff, he's looking at ways of getting cross-tools to fit down devs, which is probably a useful thing generally. It's just RPMs at the moment, but not devs. It's the correct room. So they're all trivial to fix, but we actually have to go around and do them.
I don't think the DI is going to be an issue.
Right. But apart from that, and structure testing things which might now be wrong again, because it's those specifically fixed, but just ARM in general.
Right.
I think they might now become broken again. Although mostly people just put I think people generally just put whatever it is, the special attribute packed, which I think will still work. That just stretches the same thing, so that should be fine. Because people messed it down and said, oh, it's ARM, I'll just ship the bytes around.
Let's see.
Which is a reality. Hopefully nobody did that. Okay, so I think we'll mess about this today and see what we can build. And try and find ourselves some FTP masters to hassle. Is there anything specific we need to ask in terms of getting things to happen?
I mean if you talk with AJ about like the ARM, keeping ARM being coordinate, I think that's the main issue.
Yeah.
So I think people about how they feel about that whole not having that great path issue.
We went over the upgrade thing a bit, but it's sufficiently exotic because you have to boot into a chip and then change the base system and then reboot the new kernel and then put the rest of it. And the chance of that working seems to be pretty low. So I think we just need to say, package list. Backup / /etc install.
Yeah.
It's much more likely to work.
Yeah. And I think the best analogy is just the AV64 conversion. Support people partial upgrading from i386 to AV64 on their AV64 boxes.
Right.
For some reason we should draw ARM. Because there's far less of them.
It is possible to build a kernel that does ARM style and
in theory, right?
In theory.
I was talking to think that you could actually do that. Well, the kernel works for both new ARM API and the old one. Did you?
No, the kernel, no. The kernel can, like, I believe it can use user run from the old API
or
the API.
That's only one of either.
Yeah. One or the other, but not
both, right? All at the same time, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
What's the old Navi combat flag then? I think it should be able to use them both.
Yeah.
It has, you compile the kernel as
well. Oh, okay, there's a flag in the kernel. It's not the index.
And then
it has
a flag to support the old
API
too.
Yeah, okay.
How does the kernel interface probably look like? It needs to know, of course, single line in the case.
Slightly.
Yeah, it's kind
of a bit different.
Yeah.
It's big time
different. Yeah, the new kernel Cisco convention is not actually tightly coupled to the EAV change. They just do it at the same time because they're breaking stuff anyway.
Which makes sense.
I was thinking
the EAV
change
doesn't need to be
for Cisco changes.
No, which is why there's this halfway house, the old kernel and Cisco, so 2.6.8 to 13. You can split the two things.
What's the skull shapes in it?
I don't know the actual details.
That's good.
Yeah. A couple of words onto this. It was very possible to upgrade any meaningful way.
Right.
Yeah.
If you can just skull shape.
What I'm thinking right now is like change root is not possible, but if there is a way to run UML Linux on that, that could do it.
Yeah, that's
but
true.
That will be like not a very elegant solution, but still it's like the only way I
don't
see to run UML.
Like I said, it's kind of an interesting project somewhere just to see if it can make it work, but I think we've got better things to do.
Yeah.
Moment on my desk. better.
Yeah.
yeah, I'm thought about that. I'm not quite sure when I'm supposed to give it back to Alan at some point. Yeah, now I'm kind of set up a bit forever. So, because, you know, we're just doing projects at the moment, and that's kind of till December.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a maintenance period of 6 months or something. But after that, it might, I mean, it should be able to persuade us just to leave it.
Okay.